Once again, though, we are going to be talking to a Niman Ranch farmer.
Yes, from Progressive Distributors.
This is very exciting. We have Farmer Travis we're going to be speaking to. We actually spoke to him, full disclosure, a couple of days ago.
Yes, correct.
And we had some really interesting conversations, as we have had with all the farmers. But you really want to listen, because we've got another gift basket courtesy of Progressive Distributors, Niman Ranch, and Organic Valley up for grabs.
That's right. So the question is going to be about what kind of food Travis feeds his animals. So listen for that for your chance to win a basket. As soon as he talks about that, send us the answer to 3262999. Okay, 3262999. The first person in that tells us what kind of food he feeds his animals is going to win the basket. And the first thing we asked Travis, we're going to send it to the interview now. A couple of days ago we talked to him, was how long the farm had been in his family.
Okay, I'm the fourth generation of the Flaherty family farm. I'm the only generation that has raised beef and pork for Niman Ranch. We have always, in the past, there's always been livestock, chickens and pork and beef and stuff like that. So,
wow. So four generations.
Been
around. Now, you've been with, tell me again, how long have you been with Niman during that run?
Okay. I researched the company 17 years ago, and I actually flew to the San Francisco, to the Bay Area, where they had the main office at that time, and I visited with them, and even before I left their office, it was like, I'm going to do this. And so on my flight home, I started drawing up some things and what I needed to do, and I guess when I landed in Iowa, that's when it started, and never looked back. It's been a wonderful experience with them.
I can see why, because their philosophy is a philosophy that I think a lot of us can get behind. Now, I know your slogan is Raised with Care. Can you tell us, Travis, a little bit more about what that actually means?
Well, with the Niman Ranch, what I call way is raised with care. It's, you know, putting the well-being of the animal first. Here in Iowa, you know, we have such severe winters and sub-zero cold. It's, you know, they need the food, the water, and the shelter, the three most important things for the animal. What I like about it is we give all the animals the ability and the choice to do whatever they want to do. They can go inside, they can go outside, they can dig in the dirt, they can get muddy, they can walk over there. You know, it's all about their own choices. And I believe, truly believe, with raising them that way, with care, they make their choices, and they just there's a lot less stress. And you know, it seems like with high stress, is there's always problems, whether it's a sickness or whatever. So that's what Raised with Care in my operation is.
Well, that's you're talking about stress. That's true for both animals and humans, isn't it? You know, we create these illnesses inside ourselves when we get stressed out. So, man, the more I'm hearing about Niman Ranch, the more I'm excited about this company. We've mentioned it every interview so far, Travis, but one of the things that Terry and I talk about a lot on the show is sustainably sourced food and where your food comes from. You know, there's a lot of documentaries coming out about that right now, too, including, you know, even with ocean food. Seaspiracy, that new documentary. So hearing about how you treat the animals is like so critically important to a lot of people, and they're making this a priority. But what does it mean to you to be committed to more of those traditional farming methods? Is this kind of like a, is this like an ethic that you work towards? I mean, I would assume it is, but tell us more about that.
Yeah, it's way more. I used to do it a little bit different in the past, and it's there's so much more reward, more than financial, to raise the animals this way. I guess you just have a different look at it. They're just not mass production. They're not, you know, the ultimate, I got to have that money scenario. You can raise animals and raise them humanely and with care and get product people just, you know, really enjoy it. On nice sunny days, people drive by my farm, and when the little pigs and the baby calves are out playing around, they'll stop and watch them because they don't see that. The outside hog production is a thing of the past, and in my area, And so people, I would say in their 60s and 70s grew up that way. And they just thoroughly enjoy watching the animals play outside like that.
Your farm sounds so picturesque. I can just picture right now, Travis. Next trip, Tim. It sounds like the farm, farm that people want to support. And you can see why Niman Ranch, these practices are so important to all of you guys. Now, of course, we all know what we eat. It's important for what we're eating, what the food that they ate before we ate them, of course. So what do you actually feed your animals on the farm, Travis?
Okay, all the I'm in charge of the livestock part of it, the pigs and the cattle and the chickens. And my dad is 81 and he's still farming full time. He's in charge of the grain side of the farm. So we raise all our grain here, right directly here on the farm. So we know exactly what we're feeding our livestock. We raise our primary crops are corn, soybeans, oats, alfalfa, and sometimes we plant a wheat crop just to add in like a fourth or fifth crop rotation in order to suppress weeds and stuff.
Wow.
That's incredible.
You guys keep yourself busy. I can't believe your father, 81, still a full-time farmer.
Still full-time, and I always ask him when he's going to retire, and he said, well, I got just too much stuff to get done.
So, I'm laughing because that sounds just like my grandpa.
It sounds just like my own father. I get this.
Yeah, when he was running the farm, he didn't want to leave. And even when he left, the way they did it, they passed it on to the next generation, and then they had the smaller house that the previous generation would move into. So that's how they were doing it. He didn't want, even when he went to that house, he was still on the farm every day, like 6 o'clock in the morning.
Absolutely. You just can't take that away from them. And if you did force them, I truly don't believe they would last very long because that's been their heart and their passion their entire life.
Exactly. Yeah,
once a farmer, always a farmer, I think.
That's right, yeah. Travis, thank you so much for being out with us. It's been very informative.
Okay, you betcha. And if you ever want a farm tour in North Central Iowa, you're more than welcome to always come here.
We actually might take you up on that.
Yeah,
so thank you, Travis.
You're very welcome.
Have a great day. Thank you for all the work you do in giving us this kind of quality food. We appreciate it, and take care.
Oh, you bet. And same to you.